Speaker Kraig Paulsen, everybody.
Thank you. Kraig.
Well, thank you. That was a very nice introduction. I notice, though, the only one that's got youthful vigor is Matt Schultz. I'm not sure how I feel about that. First of all, thank you for being here. I mean, we say that, and sometimes we gloss over it quickly, but I want you to know that every single one of us standing up here, every single House Republican recognizes that you could be doing a whole host of different things tonight, and you could have chosen to do something different with your contribution, and you didn't. You chose to be here. You chose to support the Republican Party of Iowa and people like myself and our caucus, and we thank you very much for that. A couple brief thoughts that I want to share with you. As you know, last year we went to June 30th. We were supposed to be done a couple weeks ago, and we're still in Des Moines. And so, you know, why are we still here? Well, I'll tell you exactly why we're here. Because before the 2010 election in November, House Republicans and the then candidates, now state representatives, promised to you that we would not spend more than we have. Seems like a relatively simple concept. It's one that apparently some of the Democrats in the Senate have trouble with, but you know, we said we're going to stand up for that, and we have. We said we're not going to use one-time money on ongoing expenses. We meant it then, and we mean it now. And we also said we would not intentionally underfund ongoing commitments or entitlement programs, knowing we would have to come back in the following year and pass a supplemental. That's why we're in Des Moines. We're fighting about money. We were fighting about money last year, and we consistently had to rebuff efforts to just push the puzzle pieces around, try to find a different way to spend money. And I will tell you, standing firm, the House Republicans, along with the Senate Republicans and Governor Branstad, we have made some remarkable differences. We went from, if you're looking back, if you look at kind of a relative number, the last budget the Democrat legislature sent to Governor Culver to sign spent roughly about $1.17 for every ongoing dollar that came into the state. In 1 year, we took that down to under a dollar because we meant it. And we will continue to work on that, you know, but I also want to simplify things just one level below that, because a lot of times there's a whole lot of government math going around, and government math generally isn't helpful to anybody, and in particular the taxpayer. But if you line up the previous General Assembly, the 83rd General Assembly, Democrat-controlled, Democrat governor, and how much money they spent, and do an apples-to-apples comparison with the 84th General Assembly, Republican House, Republican governor, we spent less money dollar for dollar in real terms, not relative terms, not accounting for inflation. We spent less money, and I think that's something we should all be excited about. We absolutely are committed to a more efficient and effective state government. I don't know, one of the other things I wanted to mention, maybe you saw some of this in the news reports this week, that House Republicans were not team players. I don't know. That all depends on who the team is now, isn't it? If the team is government and bureaucrats and growing government and all the things in the intellectual and political elite, no, we're not team players, because that's not the team we're on. What gets up us in the morning, what we fight for every single day, and what keeps us coming back is the hardworking taxpayers of Iowa, and that means you. So when you see these property tax discussions going on, and you see the Senate try to roll this bill out, it's a compromise bill, everyone's on board. Let me tell you, everybody's not on board. It's a piece of junk, doesn't protect the homeowner, and it provides no certainty to employers, and House Republicans will not pass that bill. What we will do, however, is we will pass what will end up being the fourth property tax bill in this General Assembly. We've already done three. We're going to do another one, and we're going to make sure homeowners are protected, and we're going to make sure there's real tax relief in there, and we're going to make sure that employers have certainty and that homeowners can plan for their future. We work for the taxpayer, and we'll continue to do that. A couple other things, and sometimes actually when I think about this and what we've accomplished in the last couple years, and when I say accomplished, some of that means we've sent it over to the Senate, and it's kind of a let down sometimes. I never was particularly good at baseball, but I'm smart enough to know that the pitcher's got to have somebody catching, And right now, we're doing a whole lot of pitching, and there's nobody catching over in the Senate. We've sent them ways to ensure that your Second Amendment rights are not infringed on. In fact, you may remember that day. That's the day where people got confused, or at least the House Democrats got confused on whether it's Iowa or Wisconsin, and they left the Capitol for 4 hours. They called us up. You know, if you'll agree to limit amendments or let us do this or change this in the bill, you know, we'll be right back and we'll debate this bill. And what both the leader and myself said was, last time I checked, your job is to be here, to get back here and debate the bills, and we're passing them tonight. And that's exactly what we did. We passed bills to protect life. We passed bills to address collective bargaining among government employees. We passed the voter ID bill that the secretary mentioned. We passed the 20% income tax cut. We've strengthened Iowa's right to work law, and we have done so many bills to try to make it more inviting to employers to continue to invest in Iowa and continue to invest in Iowa's workforce. I wouldn't even know where to begin. We're very serious about growing our economy. We're very serious about making sure that we have an efficient, effective state government. There's a ton of work to do. My expectation is we will get this wrapped up shortly, and then we will hit the campaign trail. We will grow our majority. We will have a Senate Republican majority next year, and we're going to get this work done because there's a whole lot left. Thank you very much.